honky-tonk. It was a different scene. No IPAs, no skinny jeans. Things are in, then they're out. But the thing that the cool kids are all saying now is country's coming back. Buy some boots and get a hat.
Alright, let's do this. We got June Clivis and the Diddy Boys, specifically Johnny Dynamite. Here we go. We're in Los Angeles, California. How are you guys doing?
We're doing great. Thank you for having us on the show.
I'm excited for you guys, one, to be on. We really appreciate it. Being that we're back in Southern California, enjoying the nice weather, you can't go wrong with that. How are you guys doing? I know it's been somewhat, well, like everybody else, it's been a difficult time with COVID, but how are you guys doing right now?
We're trying to stay our head above water right now. Looks like other musicians.
I hear you. Well, for our audience, June, if you don't mind, or Johnny, if you wanted to get into, just for people that aren't familiar with June Clivis and the Diddy Boys, or people who are, that want to learn more about you, if you don't mind, please share a little bit about your musical influences, but where you're from and a little bit about your band.
All right. Well, we're from Los Angeles, California, and we're a five-piece band. The other bandmates that aren't on here, we got Manny on the banjo, we got Zach Rabbit on stand-up bass, and we got Papa Brandt on the drums and percussion. We all have different influences from previous bands and anything from metal to alternative to punk, so this collaboration is really cool because we kind of bring a little bit of everything, but it's not that style anymore. But I think we still have our punk roots, so that's why we're outlaw country.
And we'll appreciate that since we're so close and we got a lot of outlaw country here in Texas in the Hill Country. How did you guys form in terms of as a band with being five pieces? And this is why I love you. In terms of the band, you guys have the banjo, like you said, you got the big bass player. June, your voice is so cool. And also, obviously, Johnny, too, adding in there. But how did you guys all get together as the band, as the June Clivis and the Diddy Boys?
Well, long story short, I started it with our banjo players, my uncle. We started as a little folk band at first. And from there, Johnny came in, saw a little clip that we had put on Instagram. And Johnny's like, hey, what if I play guitar for you? And I said, yeah. So Johnny came in. And then we had a different drummer and bass player at the time. But Johnny brought in Zach. And then we found Brent through a mutual friend. And it's been us for maybe a year now before the rest of the band.
Very cool. No, I really appreciate it. And you have a great, it looks like, solid faithful following, and some of the reviews that you guys have gotten have been great, and that's why I really was turned on when listening to your music. To go back to Los Angeles, and I know, and this is what I've been constantly saying each episode, is during, you know, everybody knows, specifically in the music industry and really the entertainment in general, and now we look at the hospitality industry, it's been extremely tough for a lot of people. But I wanted to make this season about, you know, overcoming those obstacles, us as being the underdogs. Everybody loves a good underdog story. And I was speaking to Johnny earlier, and I wanted to ask you, June or Johnny, if you wanted to chime in. Is there maybe something that you can think of over the past, or maybe just right now, that you're very proud of overcoming those obstacles, and looking back now, it's been a huge accomplishment for you or your band?
Well, basically, during the whole COVID thing, it's been hard because, you know, the band members are away from each other. We don't get to hang out as just friends anymore. We have been able to have some practices, and we did a couple of live stream shows, so I think it's kind of taken a little bit of a toll, but I mean, we're hanging in there. But for the most part, I think putting this lineup together, that was an obstacle in the beginning. We had some other members in the past, and then we switched them out, and we have a good bunch right now, and we all have our input in the songs, and but I think basically that we're still around here, and we got some shows coming up, one being on November 21st. I'll tell you about that a little bit later, but for the most part, we're still hanging in there, so kudos to the rest of the band members who are, you know, still sticking in there with me.
No. And all those people and fans and friends and everybody who keeps coming back and wanting more. It's awesome.
It is. It's been great just seeing what music, I mean, overcoming these obstacles, but really people just love music and want you as a band, but in specifically in general music to come back. And like you said, I'm really glad that you're able now to do this live soon. And really, I'm hoping that once this is all over, the music industry and independent musicians coming, you know, up roaring and we make a comeback story. So I can't wait for that.
I think 2021 is going to be crazy. The music business is just going to jump, I think.
Yeah.
I think everybody has these ants in his pants just waiting to run out and watch the next local show or big concert, you know. We all miss music.
I think that's the analogy I was looking for, ants in the pants. Everybody's up and roaring to go. All right. Well, Johnny, I really appreciate that. And obviously, June, too, thank you so much. Like I said, it's every story, they have somewhat of the same story, which is sad. But it's also the same story that I can just tell the positive energy. And I know that we will get over this. But,
yeah.
All right. Yeah, so sticking with this positivity moment, I'm about to pull over the white lightning for the lightning round. Are y'all ready?
We're ready.
All right, let's do this. Now, this year also, I'm promoting local high school football. And this week, we're promoting the Glen High School Grizzlies. It's a really cool logo. I don't think you can see it, but I'm very proud of this t-shirt. But we're also promoting local businesses. And June and Johnny, I was going to ask you, is there a local business that you wanted to promote in the LA, Los Angeles area?
Yeah, definitely. We got the Pike Bar in the city of Long Beach. And it's owned by Chris Reese, who used to play with Social Distortion. I don't know if you've heard of that band before.
Oh, yeah, Social D.
But obviously, he's a big supporter of music. We actually had a residency there that was supposed to happen this year. We played the first show, and then the week after, COVID shut everything down. So we didn't do the rest of the shows, but he's ready for us. He's reached out to me and said that, you know, once he has his the green light to have fans come back in, he's definitely going to have us back in there. But when COVID started, he actually he fed his employees, he fed his neighborhood. Though he wasn't making money, he was giving back out to the community, which is awesome. And if you meet him, you can have a beer with him, and he's like your friend of forever. So really cool cat, Chris Reese from the Pike Bar in Long Beach on 4th Street. So, and have the best fish and chips I've ever had. So go there.
Man, I now living in Texas and being really from the Southern United States, Southwest, and being Las Vegas, I miss Southern California, man. That Pacific Ocean, Long Beach, you got the boardwalk. Can't beat it.
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, I'm definitely making it my way after this interview. We're going there.
All right,
let's
come on
go.
Down.
Save me a beer.
Chips, let's go.
All right, let's go. Hey, you're speaking my language now. All right. June, Johnny, you ready for the lightning round?
Yes.
All right, let's do this. All right, sticking it. Since we're already talking about, you know, fish and chips, I'm going to stick it to this. Beer or whiskey?
Beer.
Pabst Blue Ribbon.
Is that the beer choice?
Of course.
I love
it. Can't go wrong with it.
That's right. That's a workman. That's blue collar right there.
And some morning to start off like that, too.
The hair of the dog. All right.
Yeah.
All right. Another, this is a music-centric question to kind of segue into the next, but I have to ask. You got this hillbilly, I was asking Johnny, really, how to describe your band. I saw a review. It mentioned that you were country neo-hillbilly rock, and I love that review because I think it really described your music. And so I have to ask this. If you had to choose Imelda May or Stray Cats?
Ooh, that's hard. You know, they're both loved very much. But we're going to have to go, my personal choice, we're going to have to go to with the Stray Cats. Shout out to Slim Jim. He's been helping us out a lot. He's been putting us out on his Rockabilly Rave Series XM show every Sunday, 5 to 6 p.m. Check it out.
That's a plug. I love it. No, that's so cool with the Stray Cats. I mean, personally helping you. And I know I just wrote that question, but I'm very glad that you were able to say that. I'm also very proud that I mentioned those two artists for you to choose from. All right. If we were driving from coast to coast as a band, if you wanted to, but if individually, if we were driving from coast to coast, what musician would you want as your co-pilot?
Go ahead, John.
I would like my whole band to be with me. By the time we get to the other coast, we'd probably have another album out or ready to go. So, but you know, when you play in a band, you have that, you gotta be professional and you play, but to have a band that you can actually kick back and have a beer with and have Sunday dinner with, that actually means a lot to me. So for this group to be together and have a road trip, that'd be awesome.
That's very cool. And also I love the creativity side of you showing right there by you, and financially, really, marketing ability that you already would have an additional album right there. I love it. June, you got one?
Well, that was that's a great answer. I don't really top Johnny's, but I've always thought if I can go on a road trip musically with someone, just two of us, I'd really enjoy a ride with Shaky Graves. This guy is just musically so talented, and off the stage, he's such a goofball. So I always said that I was like the female version of him. I think we'd be the best of friends if we just run into each other.
I'm not too familiar with Shaky Graves.
He started off kind of folky, and now he has like a full blown out like rock and roll band.
Wow.
You can still hear the country, and Yeah, you definitely check it out.
Very cool. So while we're on this road trip, and I wanted to look through your phone, through a playlist, is there a band or musician that would surprise us?
I would probably have some metal in there. So I don't know if you'd expect that or not, but I mean, you know, anything from that to Elephant Gerald, definitely I'll have my June Clivus and the Diddy Boys album playing for sure.
That's another plug. This guy's good. Oh, wow. He's been practicing.
I'm wearing my June Clivus mask.
Are you head of marketing?
I think I just got promoted to that.
Oh, nice.
So anyone wants to pick up a mask, a t-shirt, we got tank tops, we got stickers, we got koozies, we got albums.
I love it. All right. How about June, you?
I think everybody knows I grew up with a lot of influences, but I think the one that would kind of make people tilt their head a little bit is I love Missy Elliott. Sometimes I'm just driving my car and they don't expect that coming out of my car. So maybe some hip hop.
Oh, man. Yeah. Who doesn't love some like early millennial Missy Elliott? Well, hey, y'all were great answers. I mean, we're all gonna really appreciate it. I love when just musicians just become genuine and they can answer right off the cuff, so thank you very much for those. But now this is on you. So I like you just did, Johnny, you promoted the new album, you got some great just music. Go ahead, I want you to introduce your music, but also plug, how can we find you, how can we hear you, how can we follow you?
All right, well, we're on the all these social media, so you can go to Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, Spotify, iTunes, and everything is found under June Clivus and the Diddy Boys. So if you need to know how to spell that, it's right here. And yeah, so again, this is our debut album, which just came out last year. So we have this, we have t-shirts. But if anything, just stop by one of our social medias and say hello, and you know, hopefully we could be friends.
That's great. Now, do you guys have any, shout outs, plugs?
Oh yeah, we have shout out to Local Music Experience, you guys. Thank you guys so much for everything you do and everything you do for Southern California local bands. I think we would all be going crazy without you right now. You guys give us the opportunity to send any music. You send it, you show it to the world, you show it to anybody who's listening to new rock and roll or whatever's up and new coming. And thank you for always being so supportive and excited about everything we send you. We love you guys.
Yeah, Racy, Ronnie B, and Milo, thank you so much. It means a lot to us. They actually heard our music, and they plugged it right away, and they said nothing but nice things. And, you know, it's been a year and a half since then, and we really appreciate it.
Very cool. I'll definitely... we'll plug them as well. So thank you so much for sharing. And I really, like I said, I love SoCal so much, man. LA is just, I feel right at home. But I have to do it. I have to kick you out. But before we kick you out, all we ask is for a song.
Oh, yeah. It's a beautiful view out here. I'm actually on the beach right now with some butterflies.
I see that. Oh, it's very peaceful. Johnny, June, you got anything else?
I just want to give a shout out to Gretsch Guitars. Great guitars. I have electric, and Miss Clivus here has her acoustic electric, and they sound great. So if you don't have a Gretsch guitar, go check them out.
Well, yep. And that's just everywhere. You know, you're looking for an instrument. There you go. Another plug. Mm-hmm. Seriously, we appreciate your time. If I need a plug myself, I'm going to call Johnny and say, hey, help me out. thank you so much, June, Johnny, Mr. Dynamite, Mrs. Clivus. Thank you so much. We can't say enough. So thank you very much for joining. I hope you stay safe and really good luck, not only with this live music, but in 2021.
Yeah, same to you. Thank you, Nick.
Thank you,
Nick. Bandwagon TV, and much love to you, man. Keep safe, huh?
Hey, you too. Redemption story. Here we go. But we got to kick you out, so we got to ask for a song. What song are you guys playing for us today?
All right, you guys, we got something new for you. It's a little teaser for the next 2021 album. Howlin' for you. Enjoy.